Yeah. Damn you, calling your non-context having ass. Okay. I kid. Welcome, Coy. And anyone else who happens to be lurking. I started to make a gherkin reference, but that wouldn't have made sense. Lurking with the gherkin? What? Yeah, that wouldn't have worked. Anyway, we're gonna be playing Sly Cooper this evening, and I'm so fucking excited, because a couple of months ago, I believe, it was earlier this year or late last year, I looked at the Cutting Room Floor page for Sly Cooper, all three games, and it was just lovely. I found a bird with no eyes and a few other nifty things. It's fun. It's a fun time. Who knew RuneScape had such fucking bopping music, you know? It's crazy. Good old Run Escape. And thankfully, Sly Cooper has wonderful music itself, so I will not be playing music. It was pretty bad, and I didn't want to say it was bad because that would spoil the vibe. You wanted to know the context, and now you're the only one to blame. I mean, yeah, I wanted that context. Although I've heard about a lot of fucked up stuff, so do your worst. Are you scalping bees out here, Coy? Weird if so. Double check and make sure this is indie. Yes, it is indie. Cool. This is a band called Rabbit Junk. Very industrial sounding. I like it. At least the earlier stuff is. It's wonderful. Oh, yeah. I was at a mini convention a couple of weeks ago, and this person was selling magic cards. It was like, if you could to fill up a box, that one deck box was $5, which was amazing because I found some really, really cool cards. One of which was a custom made blue squid token with Island Walk, but instead of a regular squid, it's Squid Girl from the anime Squid Girl, and it's precious, and I love it. Great stuff. Well, I woke up at 3 a.m. yesterday with a huge pain in my head and neck, and then I panicked and left the house in my pajamas on foot to my mother's house. Okay, but what does that have to do with a bee without a forehead? Whatever. It's not that important. This is a word game? A pun. It's not clicking, but I'm sorry. I have as much as I love puns, some of them go right over my head, and I wish they didn't. I love me a good pun. Anywho, I am going to check something real quick. That's a lie, you bought me a latte. Anyway. Go on to the PlayStation Double. Yo, I got that PS Triple. To Xbox? Psh, nah. Hey, it was Chair Warden here. Maybe in 7 years when you can't sleep, you'll think a bee without a forehead and, I see, I understand. I don't know. I've had plenty of times where I couldn't sleep. Why is that so loud? Nah, it's alright. It's only loud for me. And once again, my fucking sound chip's messing up again. There we go. Browser System Explorer. No, it's not the browser, it's my laptop itself. Sorry, I didn't mean to bump the microphone. I have this in a, I have the first Sly Cooper not in the official case with the manual and such, it's just the disc in a generic case, which sucks, because I really want the full original trilogy with all the manuals and everything, but haven't gotten around to it yet. There we go. It's a bit hard to hear you. Oh, I fucking knew it. I don't know why some music is just louder than others. Like it's mixed louder or something. What the hell? That was weird. It's a me. Mano Kastaff. Welcome, Mano Kastaff. My memory is garbage. I don't remember your name, but welcome. Welcome, Mano. Mario. It's not Mario. Mario? It's not Mario. Anyway, I need to delete some save data I'm not using. That's what it... I'm the only orphan... Oh! Cool. Welcome. It's he. No, it's not. That's so weird that you just can have this image for some reason. Oh, that's really weird. I'm gonna delete that. Yeah, it turns out you can take pictures in Rayman 3, but I'm not sure what you could do with them. Like, what? Oh, that's silly. I like that. That in April of this year. I can leave trample, but what the fuck, Koi? Stop being weird. Yeah, we'll delete that. I'm gonna start a new game in there anyway. Also, I really hope that's not a euphemism, Koi. Yeah. Just all low caps, no punctuation.
Yahoo.
That's funny. All right. We're going to pause the music. I'm going to unplug my headphones from my laptop and put them into... I wasn't implying that you needed to put more emphasis in it, Mano, but I appreciate it.
Wahoo!
You turn into fucking Klonoa. Okay. Let's do this. Whoa. Still can't believe the no, it's like it was... If you do not, do you want to create? Yeah. I'm guessing I enjoy Slab, but I've only played the third game. Oh, you are in for a treat. The first game is nothing like the third game. The second game is more like the third game. The first game was more of a Sly Cooper, of a Crash Bandicoot clone, but it's still fun. Also, I can't believe that the fucking studio that made Sly Cooper went on to make Ghost of Tsushima. That's so crazy to me. Here comes the boy. Hello, boy. All right, I gotta adjust the brightness again. That'll work. And a little bit more. Because the VOD is always darker than I expect it to be. Alright. Oh. Of course. In order to officially start this game, can't have it without an NOG drink, and I'm trying NOS for the first time. I've never tried it. It used to be really popular at my high school. Hell yeah. And, yeah. Okay. It's citrusy. Not bad. I like it. Alright, what options do we got? Glove, glove, glove. Yeah, for real. Center screen. We're gonna center the screen more towards the left. That way, y'all can see it better. And my head's not quite in the way. Music on, of course. Speakers, mono, stereo. Controls. I'm gonna have to change those a little. Well, up looks down. No, up looks up. Up, aim down. No, jetpack. Up, fly up. Sly Queen. I got that, Koi. Yes, Queen. Sly. So good. Alrighty, let's get into it. Do you read me?
Yeah, I read you. Loud and
but I'm
very loud.
Very appropriate, Koi.
Trying to break into police headquarters does that.
Get over it, Bentley. You're safe in the van. I'm the thief here. I've got to steal that file from Inspector Carmelita Fox.
Well, count on me to be your eyes and ears, buddy. Got their security system totally scoped. To get inside, you're gonna have to go through that
air vent.
All right, I'm going in.
And don't forget you got me at the wheel, Sly. All you gotta do is grab the file and get back to the van. We'll do the rest.
Just keep that engine running, Murray. I'll be down in no time.
Hell yeah. Let's do this. Oops, wrong button. After using this sound, the antivirus sent me a notification. Are you serious? No way. Also starring Bentley the Turtle. Best Bentley parts are the lemonade drinking contest and him bullying the AV. Yeah, for real though. I love that part in 3.
Hey Bentley, I think I'm seeing things. Must be vertigo or something. Can you see those crazy blue lights?
Really? I've read about this. Master raccoon thieves are able to sense thieving opportunities.
Thieving opportunities!
As unexplainable blue auras. According to my research, all you have to do is get near them and hold down the circle button, and you should perform a super sneaky master thief move.
Hold down the circle button near blue auras. I'm on it.
By the way, yes, that is me manipulating their heads using the sticks. It's very silly. Going off what you said, Mano, Bentley has his moments in various parts of the 3 games, which I will be playing all 3 of them in a row. So it's gonna happen, and the first one is by far the shortest. And also, once we get to my PS3 collection, I'll be playing the 4th one, which is severely underrated. A lot of people were disappointed by it. I had a lot of fun with it. I don't get what everyone's problem is. My only gripe with it is that it's a little bit too long. That's it. It's just a little too long. Hang on, can I? Oh, I can't up the. Oh, okay. I thought I'd be able to turn the sound up, but I guess I can't. Also, Mano, as the series goes on, Bentley gains more and more confidence. So throughout this game, he is not very confident. Super cheesy mess, i.e. putting a Skyrim pot on NPC's head and robbing it. For real, though. That's some cartoon-ass shit.
Be extra careful here, Sly. Break one of those laser beams and you'll set off the alarms. Not to mention, you'll be fried.
Yeah, this first game is a Crash Bandicoot clone.
Nice job, you're in. Inspector Carmelita Fox's office is behind the red door.
The red door?
God bless Bentley's voice actor. I love him. Oh man. I'm just going the long way around so I can cause more destruction. Apparently I can't. Alright, let's do it.
That door must be super reinforced.
Oh yeah, okay.
Maybe there's a way to get around it.
To get around it.
All that little effect where he's like stomping on bricks. Completely ransacked the office. Aw. She's got a. What is it? She's got some pictures from Sly's past over here. Also, Carmelita is voiced by a different person every single game. They can never seem to nail down her voice. I love her voice in this first one. The second one's kind of more dull. The third one really brings it. Maybe I should insult his mental faculties.
I hacked into the police security mainframe and discovered this vault's combo. Try dialing in 937.
Looks like the dictator of my country in the 70s. What the fuck, Koi King? 1, 2, 3.
Nice job! Through the fire escape and head through the parking lot, we'll be waiting in the getaway van.
Ba-na-na-na-na. Where are you from? Koi's never told me where he's from.
Criminal! You foolish raccoon. I've caught you red-handed.
Ah, Carmelita. I haven't seen you since I gave you the slip in Bombay.
Which reminds me.
Secret for now. See? The only thing I know is that he lives in Germany. And I was gonna but that's not where he's from.
Hey, you know, that bazooka really brings out the color of your eyes. Very fetching.
You think? This pistol packs a paralyzing punch. You ought to try it. Might snap you out of your
crime spree.
And give up our little rendezvous?
Plenty of time for that once you're safely behind bars.
Love to stick around and chat, but I just dropped by to pick up this case file. I think you've had it long enough.
Hell yeah. This first soundtrack is so fucking good. It's one of the many soundtracks I have on a playlist that I made back in college. Where I've just listened to video game soundtracks while doing homework. She could join the stormtroopers already. For real, though. She's
once again, my gang and I had given Inspector Carmelita Fox the slip. I was surprised to see how well she took it.
Whew.
Finally, the secret police file I'd been searching for all these years. With this, I could avenge my family and regain possession of our most valued treasure. It all began when I was just a kid, bouncing on my father's knee. You see, I come from a long line of master thieves who kept all their secrets of sneaking and stealing in an ancient book.
The Thievius Raccoonus.
Anyone who read it learned to be especially sneaky, which is why we specialize in stealing from criminals. After all, there's no honor, no challenge, no fun stealing from ordinary people. You rip off a master criminal, and you know you're a master thief. Well, on the night I was supposed to inherit the book, 5 visitors came unannounced to our door. My father fought to protect us, but the gang of villains known as the Fiendish Five overpowered him.
Not the pipe!
Until they found the Thievius Raccoonus. Our family's manual.
Oh, that fucking crunchy ass thunder sound.
They tore the book into five pieces and split it up, each villain disappearing to the farthest corners of the world to commit dastardly crimes.
Crazy.
Broken alone, I was dumped at the town orphanage. There I met two guys who became fucking my lifelong buddies and trusted crew.
Young Murray looks so
Bentley,
goofy.
Techno genius and strategist supreme, Ed Murray, part-time driver.
Full-time Burton.
Together we pledged to track down the Fiendish Five, avenge my father, and steal back the Thievius Raccoonus. I knew I was about to face the toughest test of my life. On this mission, I would either become a master thief like my ancestors before me, or fail and allow my family name to bite the dust.
Such good voice acting.
That was a nice piece of work back there at police headquarters, Sly. Come see me if you want to check out any of your old movies. I've got them all here on my computer. Use the left analog stick to move around the hideout and the X button to select things.
Once again, Coy.
I've already plotted a route to our first target.
You make bits that lack any kind of context. And it's so confusing. In the fish hospital? Sure. Why not? Let's fucking get out of here.
The road trip gave me the time I needed to study up on Sir Raleigh the Frog. As a young man, this hot-tempered frog grew bored of his life of luxury and privilege. On a whim, he tried his hand at a bit of piracy and found it to his liking.
On a whim.
Raleigh, who quickly became addicted to crime, was brought into the Fiendish Five as chief machinist, where his evil tinkering genius rose to new heights.
Nerd!
The last reported sighting of this mad machinist was off the soggy coast of the Isle of Wrath. A small island
situated
in the middle of the perilous Welsh Triangle.
So they're near Wales. Tide of Terror. Boom, boom, bing, boom, bing, bing.
Hey, Sly, I just spotted something that's going to complicate.
Would you wear raccoon ears in a movie theater if a Sly movie ever comes to life? You know, maybe. I might.
I'll just use my climb move.
Okay, but remember.
Maybe the goggles. Maybe the face mask too.
Yeah, sure. And like that ladder there?
That is correct.
That is correct.
Do not forget, Sly. You have to get close.
Then hit the circle button to grab it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Relax, Bentley. I live for this stuff.
Yeah, and that's what worries me.
And by the way, whenever I say Crash Bandicoot clone, I mean Crash Bandicoot clone, as in one hit kills you. Getting 100 of whatever collectible gets you, in this game, it nets you a horseshoe, which allows you to take an extra hit, and you can have up to 2 horseshoes. And once you've got 2 horseshoes, then it gives you an extra life. Also, it's so easy to just fucking do donuts. It's so good. Okay. I mean, you don't use codes this time? No, not this time, Coy. This is one of the few games where I do not... This is one of the few PS2 games in my collection where I do not need codes. I didn't need codes for Rayman 3 either. Get out of here, purple eye. Electric eye. Infiltrate. Storm the gate. Oh, I love that style. Song. Storm the gate. Ninja style. Samurai. Metal pole. Climb that shit. And climb into that motherfucker. Bentley speaks like he's long overdue to take a dump. For real, he does. He's that on edge. He seems like he needs to take a big old dump.
Hold on, Sly. See those searchlights? One careless step and you'll be subjected to a
cute combustion.
You done whining? Let's go.
I'm just trying to keep you alive, partner. Fortunately for you, I launched these signal repeaters throughout Raleigh's fortress. Get close to one, and I can checkpoint your progress.
Nice.
Ooh, I can actually, if I remember it, I can actually give tidbits about the earlier versions of this game. So, those signal repeaters that he just mentioned, in the beta version of the game, they were originally two reporter characters, and that was originally like a little chest, and they would pop out of the chest and take your picture. And that was originally what was meant to be your checkpoints, was these two reporters who would just pop out and take your picture. It's honestly a lot cuter, but... So I'm not sure why they got rid of it. I guess they wanted to be like a little bit more serious? I'm not sure. But yeah, these things used to be... That flash is left over from whenever it used to be... two news reporters that would pop out and take pictures of you.
According to my amphibial positioning system, that big blimp is where Raleigh is hiding out.
You know, that blimp looks more like a machine than a hideout.
You're right, Sly. That is a storm machine. It's the reason why it never stops
raining around here.
Fucking love his voice.
Why would Raleigh want bad weather at his own hideout 24/7?
Beats me. But rain or shine, I'm gonna steal my family's book back. And if Raleigh gets in my way,
it's on.
It's on.
Now I get what you're saying about Crash. This game is more corridor-like. Absolutely it is. It is not open world at all. It would not become open world until the second one, where it was more mission-based and you had an overworld hub. Now granted, this first game does have an overworld hub, but you have to get to it first. But even then, the overworld hub takes you to individual levels. Oh, there's my first horseshoe. And sometimes you can find horseshoes just hiding out. Also, the clue bottles in this game are way easier to find than the second
nice
one.
Nice job so far, Sly. To get over the next gate, you'll need to grab onto this hook using your cane. Just jump and hit the circle button.
Got it. Jump and hit the circle button to grab onto.
He's so quiet in this game. Ooh. I can't jump over these. Oh, hubris. Damn it, what a waste of a horseshoe. Hell yeah. Whoa! Barely missed it. I need four more bottles. Correct.
If you can locate all the clues in this area,
oh, that's right. I gotta go this way. The series is so underrated. I hope it gets the Ratchet treatment. I hope. Well, honestly, Mano, it's not even finished. The series itself is not finished. The last mainline game in the series is on PlayStation 3, which is Thieves in Time, which regrettably was not very well reviewed, but I really enjoy it. But it ends on a cliffhanger. Anyway, so I don't know if you've played Thieves in Time, but it's time travel based, and you go back to the past to meet a bunch of Sly's ancestors, and it's super fucking cool. It ends with Sly getting well, I'll leave that for later, but it ends on a cliffhanger. I've only played. That's right. You already mentioned that. I'm sorry. I get ahead of myself. All right.
Press the circle to enter the vault code. The clues have led me to believe that the code for this vault is 792.
All of the clue combinations are the same, but you're not able to open the vault until you collect the bottles. It's like a mechanism that triggers once you get all of them.
Sly, you found a page from the Thievius Raccoonus. This page teaches old Drake Cooper's fast attack dive move. Press the triangle button to use it.
Hell yeah. I do kind of wish that a lot of the moves he learned here carried over into the later games, but they never do. It's a shame, but also I kind of get it. And this is the main collectible, the treasure keys. The crossed arms with the blank face. Hell yeah. And voila. That's the basic gameplay style. Oops. You know what? I'm gonna time myself and see how long it takes me to beat all the levels in this area.
Looks like the most secured location on this boat. If Raleigh's really as smart as his police files suggest, then that's where I'll find him.
Wonderful idea, but your plan is flawed.
Why?
Because it's impossible to get near him. To access Raleigh's blimp, you would have to sneak a voltage power tube. To do that without getting electrocuted, you'd have to destroy that power generator. And to do that, you need two more of Raleigh's treasure keys, which are heavily guarded.
Interesting. So when are you going to get to the impossible part?
Right. But I warned you. I've marked the areas you need to hit with holographic markers. Follow them to your objectives.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. It's your funeral.
So, the YouTuber Cat Icarus did a retrospective on all three of these games. And as a kid, he was like you, Mano, in that he played the third game first as a kid. And then went back and played the first and second games later.
Wow, you found a lucky charm. That'll protect you when you take any damage.
Thank you, Murray. And what he found was that in the first game, the Sly Gang don't feel like best friends. And as soon as Raleigh shuts up, I will explain further. Thank you. That's actually what I needed to know. It's how to get it behind me. Wasn't Millie in a wheelchair? He has not always been in a wheelchair, man. I will say that. I don't want to spoil how he ends up in the wheelchair, but it does not happen until the end of Sly 2. But anyway, what I was saying was Sly didn't think in the first game that Bentley and Sly felt like very good friends. But the way I see it is, this is the first like major life-threatening heist that they have done, and Bentley is like, you know, they're still relatively inexperienced when it comes to big jobs like this, and so Bentley is super on edge because he's never done this before. Meanwhile, Sly is maintaining his chill because he's usually out in the field and whatnot, which is why I feel like Bentley and Sly have that back and forth just now.
Better close those furnace doors. Jump and press the square button. That'll slam them shut.
He ended up in a chair with wheels because he became disabled. You are correct, Koi. but not in like, but it's in a very interesting way. Oh please! Oh thank God! So, early PS2 era ledge grabs are never a guarantee.
Moves.
Oh, now I know why you can't change the music volume level. It's because the music is very diegetic. Well, not really diegetic, but it's very dynamic. That's the word, dynamic. Because depending on where you're at and what you're doing, the music will change. If you're fighting an enemy, it'll change to very aggressive. If you're sneaking up behind somebody, it'll become really slow. Well, you know. Maybe mostly that first one, not so much the second one. Damn it, get that bottle. There we go. Last one's always a bitch. Okay, let's see. I wasn't there when you did it, so what were your thoughts on finishing Orphan? It is, I mean, I finished it before. That was my second playthrough, but I had forgotten a lot of it. Most of the game is really fun. Very silly plot. The final boss is ass. It's really annoying. Those little drones that it sends after you. Oh, it's so fucking annoying. Even with the Bite of Lightning equipped, it is the worst. It felt like I got lucky near the end. Because according to a walkthrough from like 2005, it recommended using the original Thunder ranged attack and the Bite of Lightning AoE attack for the drones. It was literally like, just charge up the fire projectile and shoot it at the robot and take out the arms first. And I was hoping you had this is mostly a joke, but like, if you had been there, I would have immediately asked what your strategy for beating it was. Because I felt like the way that I did it was the hardest way to do it. Because that boss is hard as hell. Oh, I almost biffed that one. Okay. Got it. Six more. I don't know why there's a bunch of walruses working for him, but hey, why not? Okay, I'm at 95 coins. Oh. Actually, I'm gonna try and avoid getting any more coins, so that way whenever I lose a a horseshoe, I can just grab one coin and then have another one. There's... Okay, so five more. That boss is hard, whatever you choose as a spell, but guided spells work better. Guided spells. Is that the AoE ones, or is that the projectile ones? It's probably... Well, yeah, now that I think about it, it's probably the projectile ones, the ones that you, like, charge up to produce more projectiles, I think. Because the fire ones seem to do a lot of damage, ironically, since it's the first spell that you have. What the hell? Oh, I see. Six. Hmm. the projectile ones, but some projectiles, most of them won't follow the target. Oh, okay. That's true, they won't. So far, the ones that I found that do follow the target is the darkness one and the fire one. But the darkness one is slower, and I think it does about the same amount of damage as the fire one. Bolt of Thunder and Smoke of Pain follows the target. Bolt of Thunder does it as well, okay. But yeah, the worst part about that boss fight is those little drones that he sends your way. Because they attack and dodge so fast. Also, I'm going back the way I came to get to find the rest of those clue bottles. Because every playthrough, I get every clue bottle because it unlocks the true ending. Ah, there's one. Okay, two more. No. Yeah, that works. Boom, bam. Boom, 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 boom. Bam, bam. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, bam. Doom, 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 doom. Two more.
Bummer, you can't open this vault without finding the rest of the clues.
Thank you, Mer Bentley. Not Murray. Mertley. Are you subscribed to any streaming services? Yeah, I just... not many. I mostly use the free ones like Tubi. Oh, here they are! Yeah! There we go. Anyway, yeah, I mostly use the free ones like Tubi. I have a Spotify premium account since I use it all the time, and that comes with a free basic subscription to Hulu, which allows me to marathon Scrubs whenever I want, which is wonderful because that is my comfort show. I rewatch Scrubs on and off all year round. It's a wonderful show. Very funny and silly. There are definitely some parts that do not age well, but for the most part, even back circa 2002, 2003, whenever it started, the director and creator tried to do his best to be, you know, as nice to people as he could. Anyway, I mooch off of my dad's Disney Plus account, though. Oh shit, I forgot to go back for the vault. I'm stupid. I was too busy talking. The new Orphan anime is on Hulu. The other one is on High Dive. What's High Dive? I've never heard of High Dive. That's very interesting sounding, though. I do borrow my friend's Prime Video account to watch Monk sometimes, so I will definitely check out the Orphan anime. Although I do still have that recommended viewing list that you mentioned last time. So that's still it's still on my phone. I just haven't gotten around to doing any of that yet. Because the manga that I've really been into recently is it's a few of them, like ones that I'm actively trying to collect that are brand new is like Made in Abyss, Spy Family, which I've been reading. As arrogant as this sounds, I've been reading Spy Family since 2020, like right before it blew up because of the anime. But I'm really glad it did blow up because it's such a really nice little series. It's very funny. But like, my impatient ass is like, reveal your secrets, it'll be so much easier this way. I must go by, have a nice game. See you later, Koi. Thanks for stopping by. Get you some sleep, boy. I know it's late over there. But yeah, I've been, whenever someone recommends me an anime, I tend to read the manga instead, since there's more of a complete story. But with Orphan, because there's just so much of it, I will abide by your viewing list, Mano. Yeah, Mano. Manicus. Manok. I don't know. I'm not sure what to shorten your name as. Maybe Mano. Because I don't tend to say Mano as shorthand. Since you enjoy reading, go straight to the light novels. I mean, I might, but it depends on how expensive they are. And I'm also not sure if I would enjoy them. That's why I would prefer to try the manga adaptations instead, because I can read them for free online. Unless you can find a way, unless someone has fan translated the light novels online, then I may give that a shot. Because I do enjoy me a good light novel here and there. I love the Dot Hack light novels. Those are wonderful. I have them on my mega folder. Fuck yeah! Whoa, yeah. Did you download them from somewhere? If so, let me know. Damn it. Hang on. I have... There it is. I have a straight piece of dead lip just hanging from my lips. And it's so annoying. It's almost compulsory that I have to, like, get rid of it. Fucking hate it. At 69 noise, and they were all professionally translated to English. The core story, anyway. I don't know how much of my previous our previous conversation you remember. I only remember the list that you have recommended, and I for some reason I remember that the mangas were translated, but the novels weren't, unless I'm misremembering and I got that backwards. Which I most likely did get it backwards. No! Out of my face. Shit. Not paying attention. That is a funny animation though. Press the circle to enter the vault code.
I can't believe I pieced this one together. Try 227.
I can't believe I cracked the code. Try 111. Don't worry, it's too much information to catch up to. That's fair. That's absolutely fair. What do we got?
Old Sally Cooper's fast getaway raccoon roll. Stories claim she can move faster rolling than anyone else could on the run.
I love this ability.
Hold down the triangle button to use this move.
It has no practical use.
Using L2 and R2.
It has no practical use for actual, like, exploration, but it's really fun to roll around. So the novel that didn't get translation but got a manga, which was translated, were the pre-stories. Oh, okay, got it. Gorch, gorch, gorch. Okay, now that I have the page, the level can end. Oh, itchy. And the new series is not. Oh, that's what's not translated. It's the new series. Got it. Have you checked online manga sites to see if it's been officially, to see if it's been fan translated or not? Because I'm cool with some fan translations. Like that's the only way that I was able to read through all of the World God Only Knows manga series, which is by far one of my favorites of all time. Speaking of manga, another one that I've been reading recently is The Dangers in My Heart, which I only know about that one because I kept seeing ads for it for the anime adaptation on YouTube. And I'm like, you know what, I'll give it a shot. And I ended up falling in love with it. It's so cute and very funny. No, go away. Whee! Look, that's all the roll does. Although it's gravity based, so you can't like, or rather, it's momentum based, so you can't roll uphill very well. Still, it's very silly. High class heist. Oh, it's the library one. I love the library one. No, it's not the library one. Excuse me. The light novel has the first four volumes fan translated, but they kind of suck. Well, that sucks. Hello, double clues. Orphan has like four manga adaptations. The best ones are the most recent. Oh, that's interesting. Shut up. Shut. Me and Big Aaron will be there. Such a dumb bit. Uh-oh, laser eyes. This scared the shit out of me as a kid. The old one from 1987 is a cool story. Deviates a little bit too much for my taste from the source material while being a bit rushed and shallow. Oh, that kind of sucks. Although now I'm curious, Mano, were you a fan of the series before the PS2 game came out, or did you get into the series once you played the game? Because I had never heard of Orphan before I played the game. I just saw an anime box cover at a local used game store that I go to a lot, and I'm like, $15? Sure, why not? I'll give it a shot. And the rest is history. There you are. There's those three. Oh. Aha. I made it.
Yeah, I did it.
Oh. Hell no, get out of here. It came along with my PS2 Minority Report as well. Wow, I didn't realize they made a PS2 version of Minority Report. That's funny. Zink! Cartoon-ass xylophones. Get all the ones on the lily pads? I think so. This music could almost be in Splinter Cell. Really? I didn't realize Splinter Cell had good music. I've never played any of them. But, like, the music for this game fucking rips, and it's so sad because the composer for Sly 1 died, and I don't remember when, but he wasn't the same composer. There was a different composer for Sly 2, and while I do love the music for Sly 2, I love the music for the first one so much more. It's much more jazzy in my opinion. Well, not jazzy. It sounds more industrial, like a mix of jazz and industrial. You know what I mean? You get what I mean. Oops. It don't matter. Any bottles over here? Yes, there are. One, two. Two more, which I know where those other two are. Right over meow. Bam. Bam. Bing. Okay, let's Roll, roll, roll a sponge. It's over here. Spinless is like ultra hardcore stealth. Oh wait, that's I think I played the first one and really didn't like it.
Knew what they were doing. Dial in 436.
I couldn't get past the training stage of the very first Splinter Cell game that's on the PS2. I'm not sure if that's the first game in the series, but I remember not being able to get past the fucking training stage.
These are the blueprints of Raleigh's entire operation. I wonder. Yes. I can wire this info directly into your binoculcom. It'll show you the position of nearby clues and breakable objects.
I really wish they had that for the clue bottles in number 2. That would have made them much easier to find. So this music could fit in it, but it could kind of deviate from the military vibe the game has. That's another reason why I don't really care for the Splinter Cell series, is I don't usually get into military games. My friend gave me, just straight up gave me a copy of the original Final Fantasy VII on PS1 and a copy of the original Metal Gear Solid, and I could not get into Metal Gear Solid at all. I suggest you play the PC version of Splinter Cell Chaos Theory if you'd like to. The closest thing to a PC that I have is my laptop. I have two of them, and neither of them are very powerful. Which is why I have been doing nothing but playing PS2 games, and I will continue to do nothing but play console games for stream most of the time, because my laptop cannot handle streaming and playing games at the same time. It's a 2005 game, don't worry. You'd be surprised, bro. Like, I tried to emulate Kuon, which was the PS2 horror game done by FromSoft, and it ran... It looked like it was running in slow-mo. It sucked. Ugh. Like, this thing can barely stream and run Magic the Gathering Arena at the same time. I haven't tried to play the original Half-Life with it yet, so I do want to try that, but we'll see. Because I'd like to play the first Portal on here as well. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, I'm going in the right direction. That's so funny. Whoa. Okay. Shit. Oh well. Boom, bam, 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 bam. Hello. Fucking bongos in the background. Ugh. So good. Also, as a kid, I couldn't really tell what this was. Oh, damn it. I couldn't tell it was Sir Raleigh, and I thought his hat with the black lug nuts on it, I thought those were eyes, and I thought this crease in the center was the mouth, and I could not see the face below it. So I just thought it was like a weird mechanical face. I was like, why is that there? Oh, this is one of my favorite levels.
Those rats got pegged.
Raleigh appears to have booby-trapped this entire place.
I'm gonna enjoy this.
Don't you get it, Sly? If you step on that rug, forget about becoming a master thief. You'll be a master dartboard.
Wait a second. What if I jumped into that barrel for protection?
I don't know. It looks pretty risky. And very unsanitary.
Only well, you probably played out. It... Played, huh? You probably played in a CRT TV... With what? Like, Splinter Cell? Or, like, what do you mean? Oh, I probably played the Sly 1 on a CRT. Probably, yeah. That's probably why I couldn't comprehend it. These things are so fucking goofy. I love them. Sounds like someone fitting into ill-fitting underwear. In like a cartoon.
So far, so good. I bet if you stayed still inside the barrel, the guard won't be able to see you.
Hilarious.
Even if he shines his flashlight on you.
Oh, bullcrap. I had him. What a waste. Oh well. The goofiest thing so far is the Italian mafia-like disguise and their codes you have to say in order to... Yes! That was so funny. Especially with how horrible Sly's accent is. And the thing is, that's like the best accent that Sly's voice actor can do. He's like, I am terrible at accents. He's like, you know what? Do it anyway. We'll make it a bit. And they made it a bit. It was really funny. Tenor, tenor, soprano, soprano. So alto, alto, bass, bass. Okay, so I can only do forward dive and not downward dive. Smack. I will say that Sly 3 is the goofiest, but it also has the most heart because of how it ends. And the message that it sends to the children. I do like the fact that the logo on the coins change depending on where you which overworld you're on, or you know what I mean, whose area I guess you could call it. Okay. That noise is so satisfying. My DVD got effed up. I didn't finish though. I think I stopped playing in China. My DVD got effed up. Oh, that sucks, man. And yeah, you were about halfway through the game, I think. Maybe a little over halfway. Did you have the Panda King in your party? If so, you were about halfway through. I remember recruiting the panda guy, yes. Okay, yeah, you were about halfway through. Maybe a little over? I can't remember. Oh shit, that's right, I need the barrel, I need the barrel! The fucking bass line. So the game is lengthy for a PS2 adventure? Oh, absolutely, although, I will say, it's not as long as Sly 2. Sly 2 is very long. And Sly 3 is shorter than Sly 2. But both are longer than Sly 1. Okay, so we need 8 more. In the barrel, there we go. Checking how long to beat.com. There you go, do that. I may be wrong at how long Sly 3 is, but it's definitely shorter than Sly 2. Ah, damn it. I goofed. That worked. I love how long to beat.com. I have an account on there. But I use my street name or whatever. I use my regular online name for it and not my VTuber name. So that's why, which is why I have not shared it to my VTuber profile. I tried to change the name of the account, but I couldn't figure out how to do it. I looked everywhere. Oops. Sly 1, 7 hours. Sly 2, 16 hours. Sly 3, 14.5 hours. Sly 4, 16.5 hours. Yep. Sly 4 is the longest of them all. Still a fun game, though. Bam, bam, bam. Okay, now I should be free to roam around to look for the rest of the bottles. Now there's at least a few up here, I think. Yeah, there you are, you bastards. Got him! I never played Sly 4 because I never owned a PS3, and I don't know if it's playable on emulators. I don't know if the PS3 has enough emulation function or not either. I'd be surprised if it didn't. Especially with how easy the Switch is to emulate.
Straight edge and compass, the answer was simple.
It's true.
Dial in 242.
I just know that it's the first and only Sly game to be dubbed in Brazilian and Portuguese? That's cool!
Outstanding! Another page from the Phoebus Raccoonus! This one features Dev Cooperinda's slow motion jumps. He used this to get by all kinds of airborne threats. Hit the triangle button while in the air to slow down time.
Oh, that's right. You can matrix mode it. Hang on. Is it a hold or a tap? Okay, it's a tap. So you can just... I'm not sure what good this does. It's fun, though. At the very least, you can admire the animations that he does. Sly 3, on the other hand, got dubbed in Portugal, Portuguese, but it sounds weird to my ears, kind of like you hear something with a Cockney accent. That's very interesting. Yeah. now, yes. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, is that all for this section? No, there's one more. And I know where it is. It's right up here.
Sly, see that machine wheel? If my knowledge of mechanical engineering serves me right, applying significant rotational torque to achieve maximum velocity will yield a positive result.
You mean something good might happen if I can get the wheel to spin fast enough?
Isn't that what I just said?
That joke is even funnier now because I understood it, like most of what Bentley was saying whenever he talks about rotational torque to achieve maximum velocity. It's funny because of because he really doesn't need to say it like that. Honestly, being able to
reading way off the charts in here. This must be the power source for the storm machine.
So, did you take any classes on STEM? That sounds STEM. Oh, okay. We don't have STEM here in America. In America, STEM is something else, and it stands for something else, but I don't remember what it is. But in America, STEM is government-assisted money for, like, paying for food. It's also called food stamps here. I don't know if you have that in Brazil or not, but, I have an associate's degree in art from a community college here. Science, technology, engineering. Oh! Sorry. Okay, that's right. Okay, never mind. That is a thing here. I just forgot that it was called that because I'm stupid. stupid. I took a few STEM courses in college, in community college and in university, but it was never my major. So I took Physics 101, and I really enjoyed the concepts in the class, but as soon as I realized that physics is just math with extra steps, I was so disappointed. I was so fucking disappointed that physics is just math with extra steps. What is a community college? Okay, so in America, a community college is like, it is a specific college that is for taking the basic college requirement, but it's cheaper. And it's for both short degrees, like nursing or welding or something along those lines. But you can also for a cheaper price get the basic college education courses through a community college when it's cheaper. And whenever you transfer to a major university, those college credits will transfer over, so that you essentially save like a little bit of money. That was the intention for mine, but I wound up spending 5 years there because it seemed like they kept moving the goalpost or something, and it didn't help that I had to spend multiple semesters out with no classes because the student loan policy at my particular community college was very specific, but it seemed to keep changing every semester. It's not important. Point is, I wound up spending 5 years in community college. But the courses that I did pass and got credit for were transferred to a university. That's so different from how stuff is here. Oh, I've been told that. I have a friend who lives in Poland, and I have not spoken to her in a few years, and I miss her. I don't know what happened to her. She just kind of stopped coming online for a while. Anyway, but yeah, she told me that it's a lot different there in Poland as well. Want to know how it is here? I would love to know. Because, like, the education system in the U.S. is fucking weird. But yes, I took Physics 101 as a basic college credit course that you have to get into university. Or, you know what I mean, to transfer to university. So, essentially, I should have explained this as well. The optimal path that's essentially supposed to happen with community college is you spend 2 years in community college to get the basic college courses out of the way, and then you transfer to a university where you can then spend the next 2 years focusing on your major. And that's essentially how it's supposed to work. You spend money at a cheaper university to get your basic college course credits out of the way, and then you spend the next 2 years at a university where you focus on the major, focus on your major and what you want to do. But yeah, I await your explanation, and I know you're in the middle of typing it. It's all good. Yeah. It would be very funny. We basically have private colleges and public ones. The latter is 100% free. Oh my god, that's so nice. Oh, that's so nice. But what is the quality of those public colleges? Is it like not great resources in the colleges, or is it like just as good as the private ones, except like slightly less good? If that makes sense? Because if the public colleges are free, more often than not, free schooling tends to offer lower quality education, which always sucks. And if that's not the case for Brazil, hell yeah, more power to Brazil. Basically, oh, never mind, I already read that. My bad. But you have to stand a fucking trial to enroll them. Here's the opposite. Public colleges are better than private. Really? Okay, that's very interesting. Normally in America, it's the opposite. Private schools are like better funded, The education quality is higher. But you have to, like, pass a test to get in, or in some cases, you have to go through a lottery system, where if your number gets picked, then you get enrolled. Yes, because of the currency problem, if private colleges were... colleges here were to have Harvard quality, few people would have been able to afford it. Oh, that's true, yeah. Still, I'm glad college is free over there. That's awesome. Whoop. They are funded mostly by our federal government. We have state colleges too. So what's the difference between free colleges, private colleges, and state colleges? Unless there's some private state colleges and some free state colleges, which, you know, may very well be the case. The state colleges are free too, but they are funded by the state public money. Oh, okay. So what are the free colleges funded by? Is it mostly just donations? Federal colleges funded by the overall public money. Oh, okay. Taxes. Oh, wait. Do the government not control the taxes over in Brazil? I feel like I'm missing something. Because in America, taxes are paid by the citizens to the government, which funds various stuff like road work and government benefits and whatnot. I don't know if that's how it is in the other places. I'd be surprised if it was the same. Damn it. I fucked it up. The source for the colleges are the taxes, just like the roads, etc. But I'm a little confused, because is the state run by the government, and do they not share the same, like, financial pool? Like, do they not share the same... does the state not share the same fund as the government? If not, I think I'm confusing myself, because we have state funds and government funds here in America as well. I don't... I'm bad at finances. As you can see, I suck at finances. Okay, I'm missing four clue bottles. There's one and two, three and four. There we are. We got them. It's kind of like that too. State funds, federal funds, at least that's how we call them here. Got you, I got you. Because there's the state government and then there's the federal government. But although, this is me being bad at geography, but does Brazil have individual states, or are they separated like countries? Like, does Brazil have states or countries? Or is Brazil one big country with states in it, like the U.S.? I cannot remember where the fuck the safe is for this level. Brazil is one big country like the U.S. Okay, got it. So Brazil has individual states within it. That's very interesting. I didn't know that was a thing. That's cool. I think the safe was near the start of the level. I could be wrong, but we'll go back and check. There you are.
Press the circle to enter the vault.
But most of our laws are federal.
I'm unbeatable. No code can stand before me. It's got to be 579.
But most of our laws are federal. We have a few state laws, and in the U.S. it's kind of the other way around. A little bit. In the U.S., the states have more power law-wise. So basically what happens is each state... So the government issues a series of laws. Some of them are mandatory to be followed by all states, which is a federal law, I think. Hold on.
It's an extension of the dive move you already know. Just jump and hit the triangle button near breakable objects for some fast breaking, fast collecting action.
Hell yeah. So, in the U.S., when the government makes a law, some laws are required by all states to follow, and some of them are essentially optional for some states to follow. Some states have a particular law, but other states don't. Some states allow some things while other states don't. Which can be confusing in terms of legal jurisdiction. So, like, you know, you can get arrested for, holding marijuana in one state while you can walk around within your pocket in another state. It can be very confusing. If you're trying to get away with something legally. Like, in some cases, if you do something that's legal in another state, and then come back to this, and then come back to us, but you live in a state where it's illegal, excuse me, hang on, let me rephrase that. If you do something that is legal in one state, but you live in a state where it is illegal, I cannot remember if you are able to be arrested for it or not. I could be wrong, though. I remember hearing murmurings about it, but I don't know if it's actually true. I see, we don't have that much trouble in here, because if something is legal in another state, it's probably legal in most states. See, that's the case for a lot of the laws in the U.S., but some laws, particularly weed, for some reason, is like... very contentious with different states. In some states like Colorado, you can grow it, you can have it, you can sell it, no problem. And weed's 100% legal here? Hell yeah. Good for you, Mano. Also, some states have varying degrees of legality for weed. Like in, I think it was North Carolina, weed is legal so long as it has under a percent number of THC in it. If it has low enough amounts of THC, it can legally be sold. Which is very strange. And if I remember correctly, it's mostly the southeastern states of the U.S. that have, like, the puritanical, fear of weed. I'll call it a fear, because that's basically what it is. Sucks to be a lawyer in the U.S. I mean, kind of. It only insofar as you have more books to learn. Although sometimes some lawyers never go outside of their state, so they just have to practice law in that particular state. But if you do move states, you do have to update your lawyer's license to practice in a different state. So that does complicate things a bit. It sounds like one of those door stops. Sucks to be a lawyer.
me to believe you had failed to knock out that generator.
Never was good at math.
Well, here's a real test for you. I found a way out to Raleigh's hideout, but unfortunately, it is doomed to failure.
You're not gonna tell me I have to shoot myself out of that cannon.
I'm afraid that's the only way.
Hell yeah.
Now you're talking.
You're really scaring me, man.
Anyway, you're really scaring me, man.
That thing, you had to steal all 7 of Raleigh's treasure keys.
So what are we waiting for? You show me those hollow what's-its.
You mean my holographic markers?
Yeah, yeah. And I'll swipe whatever it takes to get shot out of that cannon and steal back my family's devious raccoonus.
Okay, so if you want to learn a little more about how the law works in the U.S., there is a really cool legal YouTube channel run by an actual lawyer named Legal Eagle, and he also covers legal issues and popular legal hearings in the U.S., which is fascinating to hear about. That's his moniker, is Legal Eagle. He's real cool. This level coming up, I could not beat for the life of me as a kid. It was so hard. Whoops. And that is because it's so easy to fail the level in this game. Smack. I'm gonna get that one up, goddammit. Yeah. I see, so going back to college stuff. Yes, of course, I didn't mean to distract you. What is a major degree and etc.? We have 2 degree types here. We have the bachelor degree, and I don't know how to quite translate it, but it's something like licensing degree, which is suited for being a teacher. Okay, so there are varying levels of degree. The basic college degree with no specific major is called an associate's degree. That's the lowest one. And then a degree focusing on a specific major at the basic level is called a bachelor's degree. Like, I have a bachelor's degree in history. It was going to be in education, but due to scheduling conflicts, I had to change my degree to just history at the last second. It's a whole thing. But yes, in the U.S., you have to be a teacher, you have to have a degree. You have to have a bachelor's degree in education. And if you're being a high school teacher, which is the secondary school, I think, it's the school that you go to whenever you're between 13 and 18 years old, before college. Anyway, if you want to be a high school teacher, you have to have a bachelor's degree in the field of which you're going to teach, and a bachelor's degree in teaching. You also have to get what's known as your teacher license, or a licensure. And you do that by taking a few different tests. One of them is called Praxis, which is annoying as fuck. Oh my god. I tried to take it back when I was wanting to be a history teacher, and that thing is hard as hell. Apparently I passed all of it except for the math portion, but I suck at the math portion so bad. And I think I also failed the grammar portion. I don't quite remember. But yeah, the licensing degree here covers all the basic education from little kids to high school. That's so cool! Man, I wish that was the case here. That would have been much easier. But yeah. But you may only teach the classes your course is focused on? Yeah, absolutely. That's fair. Absolutely fair. If you got a history degree, you may not teach math. Of course not. I suck at math. I suck so bad at math. I'm awful at math. Like, I can't do math in my head. I have to have a calculator, even if it's like triple digit addition. Okay. So, this level is very hard. It works like a stick shooter, if you're familiar with that, Mano, where one stick moves the vessel around, and the other stick, whichever direction you're pointed in, that's the direction that you fire in. Like this. Yep. The pedagogy degree is a thing here as well. Do not let a crab take one into a tube. What makes, this kind of looks like the computer hacking minigame from In Sly 3. It kind of plays like it as well. So, the way that you lose is if you can't let a single crab get a chest into the, into one of those tubes. It's so annoying. Like, there's no room for error. Get back here, you bastard. Shit, 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 shit. This is so stressful! Fluffer, yeah, that works. Which, by the way, Mano, is your first language English, or is it the native Brazilian language, which you told me before, but I already forgot, and I apologize for that. Either way, if English is your second language, you speak it very well. Brazilian Portuguese. Oh, okay, so okay, that's very interesting. My dumbass thought you should actually hear me speaking English. It's like a fool. I make a fool of myself. I mean, hey, it happens. Pronouncing English is real fucking weird. Even people who speak it like natural, even people who grew up speaking it are like, why the fuck are things like this? It's absurd. So I fully get why people would struggle to speak English. It is a dumb language. I feel like it's complicated for no fucking reason. You guys eat most of the letters. That's a good bit. I like that. Oh god. This game has so many good tracks to it. Hola! For an entire fortnight! I love that so much. Oh! But yeah, my dumbass American not knowing shit. I thought people in Brazil spoke Spanish for some reason, but I know, like... Is it, does Portuguese have some similarities to Spanish? But then again, you said that your language sounds very different, and apparently there's a lot of words in Spanish that that can translate over into English. So that may not be the case after all. Never mind. Oh, okay. Whoops, wrong button. Yes, it also has similarities to Italian and French since they all come from Latin. Oh, okay. Got it. Meanwhile, the US is over here like, I'll take that language and that language and that language. It steals words from so many places. It's absurd. That's why it's so, like, weird to learn for people who don't speak it. In my opinion, anyway. Because it takes from so many different places. It takes from Germanic, it takes from Latin. Which I don't remember if Germanic languages come from Latin, but I digress. Oh yeah, just a casual eyeball jellyfish out of fucking nowhere. Hilarious. The hardest thing for me is the actual speaking part. Grammatically, English is much simpler than Portuguese. Really? That's very interesting. Does Portuguese have male and female pronunciations and a bunch of conjugations? Because I know English does not have conjugations at all. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, I think, like, English is one of the few languages that does not have, gendered pronunciations. Hell yeah, already got it. There you are.
Boom, boom, bam, bam. This one was cake. Input 719.
Bam.
Oh, you lucky Sly. This page features Karen Cooper-Giwa's coin magnet technique.
Oh, I love that one.
All she had to do was stand near money, and it would magically jump into her purse.
That's hilarious.
From now on, you'll automatically collect any coins you come near.
Pink. Pink. Right. Smack. Whoop. Bam. Dun, 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 dun. Now that I think about it, there's only about four overworlds in this game. There's Sir Raleigh the Frog, there's Mugshot, whom you meet again. We also have some accents, which change how the vowel sounds. Oh, that's interesting. That's cool as hell. Meanwhile, people in the U.S. use those accents. They use the tilde, the squiggly one, for like to imply different moods. They use the small delta symbol in math, actually, to refer to like to a number to a specific power and different stuff like that. It's very weird. Oh, what the fuck? There we go. About to kick Raleigh's ass, and up next will be Mugshot, which Mano, you got far enough to actually meet him in Sly 3, because you meet him for the second time. You meet him for the first time in Sly 1.
How delightful! We have a guest. The only thing is,
I hate unexpected guests.
Listen, Raleigh. Wipe up my family and steal what's mine.
Yeah.
Expect company.
Oh,
I'm ever so sorry. How sloppy of me not to finish the job. Obviously, we should have snuffed you out as well. So, without further ado, let me make amends by what? Bloating to gargantuan size and squashing you like the insignificant bug that you are.
Bring it on.
I love his voice. Anyway, so, whenever we write 2 to the power of 2 or 2 squared, we do write it with the small 2 up top. But our graphing calculators, for some reason, the power button, or like, you know, the power of button, is that little, it's that little triangle. And for some reason, that's just how the calculator, like, represents it for some reason. Same happens here, mostly because we probably import our calculators from the US. Probably. Wouldn't surprise me. Damn it, I missed. How old are you, if I may ask? I am 29. I turned 29 earlier this year. Damn it. I never do feel my age, though. I've never felt old whenever someone's like, "Oh shit, dude, Sly Cooper came out over 20 years ago," and I'm like, "Yeah, that's how time works. It's not a mystery." And that's when I'm reminded that not a lot of people keep track of how time passes. I'm 26, I turned 27 in like a week. Nice! Happy early birthday, my guy! Oh, I hit the woody part. Woodiness. There we go.
Blast it all! You've beaten me!
Well, gloat all you want, Sly Cooper. You're no match for Mugshot, my villainous cohort in Utah. You'll see. Mesa City is so well guarded, a snake couldn't slither in without setting off alarms.
Raleigh's section of the Thievius Raccoonus held detailed instructions on how to perform my ancestor Ryoichi Cooper's ninja spire jump, a technique he developed while sneaking into the thickly fortified castles of feudal Japan. Finding a way off Raleigh's boat got a little tricky with the untimely arrival of Inspector Fox, who, failing to find me, busted Raleigh and his crew.
Sweet.
With the storm machine out of commission, boats found their way back onto the ocean, and the mystery of the Welsh Triangle faded from memory. My gang and I loafed around England for a while, enjoying the pleasant weather, and then headed back home, excited for our next heist.
I took the liberty of pinning your mission map up on the wall. You can use it to warp directly to any levels you've already visited.
Yeah. I'm not sure what you mean, hot chick with gun, but she is a fox. Who cares if she's a fox, bro? Nothing wrong with being a furry. Carmelita's hot.
We're all set to go to Mesa City.
We don't furry shame around here.
It had been a while since I'd been back in the U.S. Next up, the notorious Mugshot. Ruthless muscle of the fiendish five. What he lacked in brains, he definitely made up for in brawn. Turns out he wasn't always that way. He grew up as the run of the litter. a neighborhood
weakling. Oh. Got it. That flew over my head. Sorry about that.
The were usually found on the big screen.
The dog father.
That he spotted his first gangster, and he knew instantly that that's what he wanted to be. He spent the rest of his youth working real hard to get there, fueled on his dreams of great power and respect.
Yeah, the dog father.
With enough perspiration, he realized that dream. He'd become a hard-boiled, street-brawling, tough-as-nails gangster, ensuring that he never be kicked on or pushed around again.
But he skipped leg day. And
so
that is his downfall.
I've always wanted to go to that thriving American boomtown.
Sunset Snake Eyes. That's what we call it. That's what we call his crash shape. Yeah, he do be looking. Crash do be looking fucking hench, as the British like to say. He's fucking hench. He has no neck. I always struggle to find all the bottles in this first layer area.
Hey, Sly, I thought you said Mesa City was going to be loud and busy. This looks more like a ghost town.
Something's happened. Where is everyone?
I don't know, but it's starting to give me the creeps. What do you say we take off?
And miss all the fun?
Hell
besides,
no.
I want to try out that new move I got from Raleigh's section of the Thievius Raccoonus.
You mean the Ninja Spire jump?
Yeah. Do me a favor and read me the instructions again.
To land safely upon diminutive points, leapeth lively and presseth the triggering device with the round geometrical object emblazoned upon it.
So jump and hit the circle button to land in narrow spots.
That's a rough translation.
Oh, that's a good bit, though. I like that. Round, narrow spots. I don't know why, but this kind of music vaguely reminds me of the PS1 Spider-Man games. I wouldn't know. I never played those. Part of me has always wanted to try them, but I've always been so worried that that I've been too spoiled by Marvel's Spider-Man on PS4 that I wouldn't like it as much. But I mean, I still replay through the Spider-Man the movie the game from PlayStation 2, and I love that game, so I may give it a shot one of these days. Oh, that's right. That's right. They're kind of like a nerfed version of the movie version. I don't know, man. The movie version is pretty nerfed already. I've been told they're really good, though. Damn it, I tried to hit the... Oh, I didn't. There, that's the one. That's the one. That's what I want.
What's with those flashing lights?
The latest in high-tech security. Electronic floor sensors. Step on them and you're a goner.
Goner.
Nice touch.
They're safe to walk on while flashing. But it also means they're about to switch to a different sector.
Hell yeah. That's terrifying. Let's see. Bottles. Who's got the... Whoop. Especially the first one. Play the PC or Dreamcast version. They have almost PS2 graphics. Ooh, I love me some PS2 graphics. But I also enjoy... PlayStation 1 graphics as well. The blocky textures are nostalgic for me, even though I never grew up with a... Even though I never grew up with a PS1. I grew up with a PS2. My first console was a Sega Genesis. The first game I ever played was Sonic the Hedgehog 1. And then for some reason... All the way he drove... I know, that was so silly. I love it. The death animations in this game are surprisingly silly, given what happened, given, you know, the fact that he's just fucking dying. Oh, yeah, I made it. Fuck yeah. He went down with the ship. And I will put my hands up in surrender. Whoa. Hi-ya. Alright, cool. Roll. I don't know why I did that. I can't jump like that. That was perfectly timed. Oh my god. That's so funny. It plays like the third game, but on a more linear scale. Yeah, that's basically Sly Coop. That's basically Sly 1 in a nutshell. And Sly 2 is basically Sly 3, except with a different plot. And, Bentley is not in a wheelchair. Oh fuck. Oh my god, I am missing so many. Where are they? Hell yeah. That was cool as fuck. Oh, that's where the safe is, never mind. Almost to 30. Do you like video game history? I adore video game history. Like, if I knew there was any money in it, I would have gone straight to. I would have gotten a job in video game history. That's partially why I became a VTuber, was to, teach a little bit of video game history, which is why usually every Thursday, I go to tcrf.net or the cutting room floor and look at early or unused stuff from video games. I have looked through the TCRF pages for this game and the two sequels as well, and there was a cut. I told you about the two reporters that acted as your checkpoint system in the beta version. The ones you love. You would love the mini documented cloth map. Dude, here. Cloth map? Cloth map. That doesn't ring any bells. I'm missing 5 bottles. Oh, I hate it. This is why. This is why. I always miss, like, a weirdly large amount, and I don't know where the fuck they are. Ugh. Hmm. Whoop. Okay, I was so worried that I did not jump high enough for that. Roll. There's one. Thank you. All right, now I'm missing 4. Mini documentary cloud map did here. Is Cloud Map the name of the documentary or the person or the username of the person who made the documentary? Because I haven't heard of either. It's the YouTube channel. Oh, okay. It was hosted by Drew Scanion? I've never heard of that person either. Hold on, let me look that up real quick, and then... Cloth Map. Drew Scanlon. Where are we going first? Revealed? This doesn't really look like... Oh, it is the blinking guy from the meme. That's cool. I didn't know that's who that was. Eurovision. Chernobyl. I don't really see his... video on... Huh. Oh, thank you. That would be better. I appreciate that. Let me open chat real quick. Hang in there, Sly. Confirm. Okay, it's muted. Oh, the channel is called Cloth Map. Brazil's video game gray market. Ooh, this looks cool as fuck, dude. 100%. I'm adding that to my watch later list so I can watch it after stream. Hell yeah, man. Fuck yeah. That's awesome. Okay, now where are you? Okay, we can't break back there. We can... Okay, I already got the... I got the bottles from here. What is that? What is that? Oh, damn it. I can't... It's a little puppo that's got either blood or ketchup on it. You make the call. That's basically how we knew video games via gray market. That's awesome. But also kind of sad that, like, a lot of gaming publishers just chose not to publish games in Brazil. At least not officially, I guess? I don't know. How did I miss these two? What the fuck? Okay, now I'm missing two more. Where are you, you bastards? I know you're out there somewhere, eh, Steve? I track you to Barodu! Shout out to anyone who remembers that bit. That scenario changed from the mid-2000s up to today. Oh, that's good? Unless the scenario changed for the worse. I don't know. If it changed for the better, hell yeah. There you are! I'm fucking blind. Ubisoft was basically one of the first publishers to embrace our market. Oh. I'm glad you had a publisher to embrace the market, but... Oh, boy. Ubisoft. They make good games, but my god, some of the devs and higher-ups are absolute pieces of shit. Ubisoft protected and covered up known abusers because they make good games. Back in the 2010s, they were gold, though. That's fair. That's absolutely fair. And hey, I still have some Ubisoft games. And if there's an Ubisoft game that I actually want to buy that's new, hold on. I will buy it secondhand, because... I can't help that it's already been bought, but I can at least not contribute to that. And I can give a local game store... money instead of the company. The Cooper's patented explosive hat technique. Use the triangle button to toss your cap, then use the triangle button again to detonate it. Better back off to a safe distance first. But yeah, I usually buy games used anyway. I rarely, if ever, buy games brand new. And even then, I usually only buy them at like places where brand new games are cheaper. I do not know if they have Walmarts in Brazil, but Walmart is a big retail chain that usually has discounted stuff at cheaper prices. Hold on. I actually want to do some currency conversions. We had Walmart, but they kind of didn't work here due to their sales strategies. Oh, that's very interesting. I didn't know that. That's fascinating to hear. Okay, so if Google is correct, they constantly keep lower prices as a standard, yeah. But we like big sales. Oh, that's very interesting. So they never had sales. Oh, okay. That's very interesting. By the way, is the Brazilian currency the real or the real? Is it real or real? Either way. Yes, yes. Okay, cool. So, 60. Oh, nope, that's backwards. To real. Wow, damn, the conversion rate from USD to real is crazy. So, the average price for a brand new video game in the US is $60 or 293.4 reals. And Walmart here sells them for 244.50 reals. So it's like a 10 difference, 10 unit difference or so, but it's still cheaper than paying that much more. And some more recent games are going up to 342 real or 70 USD, and it's absurd. I bought Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom for 60 USD by pre-ordering it from Play Asia, because everywhere else wanted 70 to pre-order it. I'm like, no thank you. Fuck your $70 games. Also, this is my second favorite ability. It's a fucking hat mine, which is so funny. It's very situational, though. You really have to set it up for it to work properly. Smack! Bam! I see. Now, here's the catch. Remember when I told you that most of our laws are federal? So is our minimum wage. It is capped at 1302. Imagine spending nearly 300 in a single game. That's why gaming is such an expensive hobby here. Oh yeah, so much piracy going on. Absolutely fair. Absolutely fair. Although I do want to convert that. Oh man, I gotta jump. Okay. 1402. Is that... So I know our minimum wage is monthly. Thank you for that. Wow, monthly. 266.25. Divided by 31 days. No, not 31. Divided by 7 days. I don't think that's right either. I'm trying to, the way that payment works in the US is some jobs pay monthly, other jobs pay weekly or bi-weekly. So every week every week you get paid or every 2 weeks you get paid. And I was trying to divide divide that monthly wage into a weekly payment to figure out like how much you get paid per hour, but I could not math that. I couldn't figure out how to do what math to do. I think it's better weekly. Okay. Because in the US, the average hourly wage is between, let's see, USD to real. The average hourly wage for real is between 45.33 real and 53.79 real. Now, granted, not every company pays that little. Some go as high as 63.57 real. It would be 6 an hour. Oh my god. Wait, hold on. 6 an hour. 6 real to USD. Oh, that's horrible. $1. What about $1.23 an hour? That's horrid. Good god. You could not, like, you can barely live on 53 real an hour in the US.
Well, this mugshot certainly isn't shy. Okay, so we know he's here somewhere, but how are we supposed to find him? Mesa City is a big place.
Big place!
A bulldog, it seems only reasonable to assume that he chose to live in a giant fire hydrant.
That's some sound logic, Sly. Now you just need to find a way to break into the building's base.
Oh, I'm sure I'll think of something.
We don't expend in dollars, so keep that in mind. Some stuff are cheaper, like basic groceries, fruits, etc. Oh, that's right. But the imported stuff like hardware are expensive. Yeah, that's very true, because it probably keeps its market value from the US to Brazil, doesn't it? If so, absolute dog shit. Horrid. Oops. Oops. My bad. I didn't mean to do that. Ka-chunk. Bam, 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 bam. Whoa, that still feels weird to do, even though it's happened before. I played. In my dream, it would keep the U.S. market value. The PS5 here begin at nearly 3 times the U.S. price. What the fuck? That's so dumb.
Murray is in position to make a run for this key.
Oh, I remember this part.
So what do I do?
Provide some covering fire for him with that blasting station.
Hell yeah.
Use the left analog stick to aim.
And press the square button to fire.
I'll do my best.
Blaming on our dumb taxing system. Is that why? I thought it was because of the U.S. publisher's fault that did that. Kind of their fault in the software department. Yeah, that's fair. Sony charges the full 60 USD prices for games. That's still dumb as hell. That's still too much for a brand new video game. Even in the US. Especially since these are billion-dollar companies that are making these games, but they won't pay their programmers enough, and the heads of the companies are making way too much for being the head of a company.
I'm halfway there.
Halfway there. Nope. While Steam has the regional pricing system, which lowers the dollar price here. But it rose up recently due to people from other countries buying games from here, Russia, Argentina. That's dumb as fuck, man. That's not even your fault. Oh, that's cool. Murray inherits my inherits both of my horseshoes. That's cool as fuck.
Bingo! Getting pretty close.
Yeah, don't say it like that. Yep, that's why Horizon Zero Dawn doubled its price during pre-sale and launch on Steam. That's so stupid, man. I thought he was gonna eat it for some reason. Whoa. Okay. Bam. Oh yeah, I sort of mentioned this earlier, but I forgot to continue on it. This game only has 4 overworlds, and so we, as soon as we beat this this overworld, we are technically halfway through the game. I will try to get the second world done before stream ends, but we'll see. Depends on how long it takes me to get all the bottles. Let's see, how many are outside? Murray's Big Gamble. 2. At the dog track. Boneyard. Getting all the bottles is a must for the true ending. Correct, it is. Because the safes that contain the pages, they're pages of the Thievius Raccoonus. They're like, it's like getting his family's legacy back. And if you don't get them all back, or if you don't get all the pages back, then you, once you beat the boss, it's just kind of over. Like, yeah, you'll see. You'll see. Dang, it's only been 2 hours and 17 minutes. We got this. Boneyard Casino. Oh, I remember this part. There we go.
Nice job getting in, but look out for those guards.
Guards!
Machine gun toting dogs hunting like a pack.
Hell yeah. Makes sense, BRB. Alright, Mono, see you in a sec. Damn it, I forgot. You can't get up there. How far does he walk? Okay, he just walks that way and then turns. Oh, I can get a 2-for-1. Easy peasy. Living greasy. Shrunk. Now, I don't know if this will hit both of them or just one. Either way, it shouldn't alert the other one. They should just be like, oh, what was that? That was weird. Oh, perfect. Oh, what the fuck? What a waste of a horseshoe, man. How did he see me? I didn't realize his spotlight could go up that high. That seems a bit silly. Okay. Nope. Oh, I can break these up. Part of me can't wait for October because I love playing spoopy games in the spoopy season. It's the spoopy month! Boom, boom, bam. Mm. Oh! Nope. Oh, yeah. I can't believe I missed both of them. And I still lived. Oh, that's so silly. Damn, there's 40 of them in here. Shit. I'm not sure if this is a long level or if there's just a bunch crammed into a smaller one. We'll see. Oops. Boom. Boom, boom. Meow. Hell yeah, there we go. Hell yeah, got one of my horseshoes back. Why is the camera angled downward like this? It seems a bit... Okay, never mind, we're good. Oh, barely missed. Oh, magic! Holy crap, it's David Copperfield. Fuck yeah. 20 coins. Psych you out. Brion, brion, brion. Pew, pew, pew. There's one. There's another one. It's like Sandy from Battle for Bikini Bottom. There's another one. Still can't believe the fucking plot of that game. And I have it. I have 3 different SpongeBob movie games. And I'm going to play them back to fucking back. It's going to be great. Nice little SpongeBob marathon. And we're getting close to it, actually. We have, slide 2, 3, that one. We have 7 more games to go before we get to, the SpongeBob games. And even then, most of the ones that are in front of it are showcase games that don't require full playthroughs. Or rather, they're not necessary. Nice. Oh, you bitch. I wasn't paying attention. That's partially my fault. I'm gonna get them legs. Bam! There we go. Oh yeah, I remember these parts. Or these, like, roulette tables. Damn it, get off and just... Damn. Okay, now we're missing 9, 8, 7. Welcome back, Mano. Man-o-war. Oh, itchy. Okay, let's see. Oh boy. I didn't realize how much of a reach that guy's. What the? God damn it. Hate wasting horseshoes like that. Falling into shit that I shouldn't be falling into. Okay, we're missing 4. God damn it, that's a game. That's a life. Not game, that's life. No game, no life. Okay, that's not that far back. That's good. Whoop. There we go. Oh, one more. There it is. Hell yeah. Fuck yeah. Guy's suddenly in Vegas. Yeah, welcome to Mesa City.
Man, I'm getting swift with deciphering these codes. Dial 338.
Also, I think it's really funny that that Vegas is such a popular destination that even people outside of the U.S. know about Vegas. It's very funny to me.
Okay, this page is from your hyperactive ancestor, B.F. Cooper. He discovered a way to speed up the clock. Perfect for those long stakeouts. Just hold down the triangle button to use it.
Oh, that can actually be used. Your country does a very good job at advertising its local features for the world. You're not wrong. Some would argue we do it to an annoying degree. I'm some. Okay, that's one, or that's two down. Hell yeah, bitch. I've never understood why the treasure keys look like Sir Raleigh's hat. Imagine being 10 and hearing jump counterclockwise. Yeah, true. But I never got this far as a child. That part with the submarine and the crabs, that's as far as I got as a kid. Bam. This will actually work. Nope. Okay, he has a set spot where he goes. Rolling around at the speed of... Whoa! Didn't mean to do that. Wasn't paying attention. Let's see if I can remember... I always forget where the markers are. Okay, one right there. One over there, one over there. Are there three or four of them in here? There's four of them in here. At the dog track. There's one, there's two. Where the hell is the other one? Oh wait, I think that is the dog track one. Let me double check and see which one's which. No, that's Back Alley Heist. Back Alley Heist. At the dog track is down on the first floor? Question mark? Oh! Don't want to find out just yet. You work on a regular job? I do. I have a regular job. Okay. I'm a substitute teacher.
My X-ray detection devices reveal that a secret elevator to Mugshot's penthouse is contained within that giant head.
So that giant head.
Wall, there's a lever that summons the elevator, but you need all 7 keys to open it up.
I'm on it.
So I'm a pseudo teacher. I don't actually teach anything. I just hand out the work that the teacher is left behind. And then I just sit and watch the students while listening to music on my Bluetooth speaker, which they do allow, which I was pleasantly surprised by. I'm really glad that they allow that, because I love music. I am quite the audiophile. How the hell do I get up there? Oh, the mattress right in fucking front of me, that might help. Okay. Is this the dog track, or is straight to the top? Back Alley Heist, straight to the top. Cool, I'm in a philosophy graduation. Earn some coin by selling sweets. That's cool as fuck, dude. Philosophy graduate, that's awesome. Where the fuck is at the dog track? Is it like lowered down? Hmm. Plan to be a professor, so I have a long road. You absolutely do. You have more patience for that than I do. You really do. Plus, your college system is mostly free, or completely free, and the US one isn't. Like, if I had the money, I would go back and get my teaching license, but it is expensive. Very expensive. Where, which one of these did I not do yet? I'm guessing it's this one. Yep, okay, it's this one that I haven't been to yet. Now it's ringing bells. I basically have to pay for the lunch and that's it. I know student debt is a serious issue in your... Oh, for sure. It is absurd how bad student debt is here.
Murray, what's going on down there?
Now it's time for one of the hardest parts of the first Sly Cooper game and one of the least enjoyed. I don't mind this. Once you get the hang of it, it's kind of easy to do.
Yeah, three times around the track for a key.
It's all you, man. Drive the van with the left analog stick. And if you manage to pick up any nitro power-ups, you can get a boost by pressing the square button. Go get them.
I'm on it.
The van physics in this game are real janky, but like I said, if you can manage to figure it out, it's doable. Shit. Part of me wondered if I can't just like get a degree in another country for free. And then come back with my degree, because that'd be fucking great. But I'd have to pay for housing as well, which I don't have the money for. Can't be worse than zero planes in GTA. I don't know. Oh, wait, GTA San Andreas. I never played San Andreas. I've been told it's really good, but I never got into it. I haven't really gotten into many of the GTA games. Like, the most recent one that I've played is GTA 4. Which no one ever talks about 4, but it's good. It's a fun game. The plot's very interesting. I don't know. Oh, fuck. I don't think I'm gonna make this one. I'm way too far. I've been too far behind for too long. Unless I can manage to shoot from 4th to 1st. We'll see. Has hands down one of the best plots, but the game is too realistic in physics. It's a turnoff for a lot of people. The physics is the issue? Is the issue? Seriously? GTA 5 has less realistic physics? That's very strange. Yeah, I'm restarting it. I never knew that GTA 5 had less realistic physics than 4. That's crazy. Surprisingly, yes, that's interesting. I mean, I never cared for GTA 5 anyway. That's what makes it easier. Oh, I see. I never noticed it was real. It was meant to be realistic. Oh my god, nope. That's not gonna happen again. I need to pass cars on the first lap. Otherwise, it ain't gonna happen. Sucker happen! It just won't fuck! Oh, I have fucked up again. That's what makes. Oh, I already read that. My bad. if you can, I don't know if you can tell, but the physics of the van are incredibly slippery. Oh, come on, you bitch. Stop passing me. Passed at least one person. Not bad, but I need to make up more ground. And the fact that I keep running into walls is what's hurting me the most. And sliding like that. It's like they tampered your van tires with infinite supply of soap. For real. It's so bad. But it can be the slide can be canceled out with the nitro. Oh my god. Which sucks, because I am actually a fan of racing games, not the more realistic ones, more so arcadey ones. Like Mario Kart, that new Hot Wheels racing game that came out a couple of years ago, which I cannot wait for the sequel for. It looks so good. I also enjoy a few older Need for Speed games as well, particularly the Hot Pursuit games. I have Need for Speed Hot Pursuit 2 on PS2, which I played a couple of weeks ago, and I have the Hot Pursuit 1 remake on Switch, and it's so much fun. Damn, man, yet again. This is rough. Bark, bark. Fuckers, and they stole the first boost. So far, this round's looking a lot better now that I'm boosting around corners. Yeah, okay, that's the ticket. You have to boost around the corners. And they stole my fucking Nitro. Oh, that time I whiffed it. Oh, damn it. I whiffed it again. Damn it, I got slowed down by another. I usually try to keep at least one extra nitro in the slot. Eat shit, 64, come on! Oh, you bastard. Yes! Okay. I just need to pass that guy up front. If I'll make it this time, though. Oh, I missed it! The fucking Nitro again! Hey, I think I fucked myself. Yeah, it's game. Damn it! At least now I remember what to do. I have to boost on the corners and nowhere else. Because that saves me. Oh, you absolute shitheel. Oh, I hate it when they steal the Nitro like that. It seems to come... Yo, one of them fucked up! Those duckers stealing our Nitro. Damn it! Well, I slid right around that fucking Nitro. That's so dumb. Oh, man. And I hit the wall again. Nope, not happening. Those duckers. I'm not sure if you intentionally said duckers or if you were just fucking around. Oh, yes! Oh, you fucker! It's so random, the ones that they steal. It's very odd. I intentionally censored myself. For comedy, absolutely fair. Okay. Okay. You bastard! You may not have killed Kenny, but it feels like you did. Now you see why this level is like the worst in the first game. There's two of these in the game. There's one in this stage and one in a China-based stage. And yes, you go to China in Sly 1 and 3, and there is a specific reason why. And it's a very interesting reason why. Oh, you bastard! No! Oh my god. This game could really use a remake. I would prefer a remaster, or if they're gonna do a remake, make a shot-for-shot remake, but make these levels much easier. Cause this is absurd. Damn it, I didn't boost on the turn. I didn't boost on the turn. Oh my god, why did he slow down there? It's like they tested something, that's what I saw. Hold on, I'll read your message in a second, Mano. Get fucking bent, loser. Wow, two people passed in one lap. That's a good sign. Ugh. Man, every time, oh my god, dude, that slide was awful. Still, we're only on lap two, we got this. It's in the fucking bag. Is that a fucking mariachi band? It is a mariachi band. That makes me feel a little better. It's a fucking mariachi band. That's not... Bring out the mariachi band! That's not mariachi! Okay, I just need to maintain the lead and we'll be good. Maintain. Come on, we got this. Bam, it's like... They tested a level once and said, that's a wrap. Absolutely fair. It do be feeling like that.
Yeah. Oh. No stretching. Oh, that's better.
Hell yeah. Instantly saves the game. I am lucky in that the game auto saves. Hold on, I'm finished with the NOS energy drink. Yeah. I want to crush the can real quick. So I'm going to mute the mic so it's not annoying sounding. One moment. Thank you. Thank you, Mono. I appreciate that. What I was explaining a moment ago is I, whenever I crush a can, I don't just, like, crush it in a crazy way. I pinch it so that there's a crease in the center of the can. And so that, like, you know how whenever you crush a can in the center, the sides get pointy? I take either side of the can, the top and bottom, and then I, like, I wriggle it back and forth so that the crease at the edges of the, at the pointy ends of the can wear away and form a little hole. And then I tilt the can sideways and suck. And I suck out the little bit that's left in there. Because waste not, want not. What's up, card dog? No! That sounds quite hard to visualize. I apologize for that. Dum, bum, bam. I guess the way that I can describe the way that I crush this can, or not really crush the can, but like dispose of the can, I guess, is like you have a hold on.
Smash that thick glass. You'll need something super heavy, like that big wrecky ball up there.
Anyway. So imagine that you have a... Hold on. I got followed! I got followed by Vorpil! I don't know why I never got the notification. I probably wasn't paying attention. Thank you, Vorpil, if you're still in chat, for the follow. I very much appreciate it. Oh, they're gone. Damn it. Oh, well. I don't know why it didn't tell me that. Man, either way, thank you, Vorpil, for the follow. Welcome, welcome.
See those neon tubes? I know they look like you can't climb on them, but with your thieving skills, I bet you could pull it off.
Any but. Imagine you have a like a regular unsqueezed can in your hands. You grip the can with both hands and you place your index finger, both your index fingers and your thumbs at the center of the can, and then you squeeze inward, which will crease, which will like make a like a like a which will make the can the it makes the can's top and bottom bend forward. And so you take that bend and you grab the top and bottom of the can and you flex it inward and outward. Like you, it's kind of like whenever you crease a paper, whenever you fold a piece of paper in half and then you crease it, and then if you want that crease to stay, you fold it the opposite way and then crease it again. It's a similar thing to that, where instead of a can, instead of a piece of paper, you're holding a can and you sort of bend it forward and backwards until these very small holes. You kind of make like a U with the can. A little bit, yeah, a little bit like a U. And, you know how parts of the U, where the center of the can was, there's now little points because the metal has bent forward and like a little bit outward. If you keep flexing that bend, it'll eventually break holes into the can. Like little small holes. Enough to suck out the rest of the juice. Look at all that juice. I never have played Gears of War. What the fuck? I didn't... That was kind of funny. Man's all juiced up. Yeah, for real. Oh, get over here. Thank you, checkpoint marker. Damn, there's 40 in here too? Fuck, alright. Alright, got that one. That one. Bring it on. No. Too late, you had your chance. Oh, I love this part. Bottle dispenser. Ugh, the way that thing gyrates is really weird. Being a Persona game, it does, but also like a more thematically subdued Persona game. Like, real chill vibes instead of, like, crazy jazz vibes. But yeah, this is what I mean whenever I mention the style of this game's soundtrack. It has... Excuse me. It has, like, an overall theme, a feel to it that's very hard to describe. Ugh. I kind of wish that thing wouldn't flash every time I walked by it. Oh, so close to another horseshoe. Yeah, there we go. We love to see it.
I love to smoke.
That's a very silly... late 90s slash early 2000s comedy bit.
I love to smoke. I smoke 7,000 packs a day.
Oh, 10 more. Can we do it? There we go. Boom, ba doom, ba doom, boom. Oh, itchy nose. Itchy nose. Okay. Is there some up here? I always forget. Oh, yeah. There we go. 7 more. Come on, baby. Oh, I didn't even see that guy. Okay, be real careful here. Okay, got it. That's so dumb. Car just hanging by a fucking magnet. Oh, okay. Bam, 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 bam. But yeah, if you ever get the time, or if you're doing like classwork and you want some music to listen to, the entirety of the Sly Cooper 1 soundtrack is on YouTube for as long as people keep uploading it. It's so good. Why is the camera like locking me? Oh, I love this part. Bam! Okay, got it. What am I missing? Oh, I'm missing one. Where's the? I think I know where the one is. There it is. There's the one. Bam!
Press the circle to enter the vault code.
Come on, Bentley.
You need an IQ of at least 140 to figure this one out.
Bullshit.
Dial in 468.
Oh, 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 oh. Sorry.
Additions to Mesa City.
Hell yeah.
With these files, I'll be able to help you find all his clues and breakables.
Hell
just
yeah.
Look through your binoculum to get the information.
We love to see it. Because that's how those things work. Bam! I feel like that's not what it would sound like if he did that. That's always kind of bugged me. That loud sword sheathy sound. Sly Cooper weighs 400 pounds. Well, see, he was on top of Oh, I don't remember what the fuck it's called. The demolition ball crane thingy. He somehow managed to operate it from the swingy ball. Now, will this actually hide me? It will. Later, bitch. This is the one with Carmelita. There's two or maybe three of levels like this throughout the game. And they're always the hardest because you have to both avoid Carmelita's gunfire and focus on trying to find the bottles. No. She should show up once I get to that roof, I believe. Oh! Pew, pew, pew. Yeah, there she is.
Well, well, well. Look who just walked into my crosshairs. Sly Cooper.
About time you showed up, Miss Fox. Was getting worried about you. Thought you took a wrong turn somewhere back in Paris.
The only one making wrong turns is you, Sly. I'd suggest you surrender before I paralyze you with my good friend, the shock pistol.
Now see, a girl whose best friend's a firearm's got issues.
Yep.
A little dinner, a little dancing. I think I can help you out.
Sounds romantic. As long as you don't mind dining in jail.
Nah, I hear the service is lousy.
Once I catch you, you'll know for yourself.
I love their back and forth. It's so nice. Oh, here we go. Whoa. Okay, there's 30 in this level, which seems a bit excessive for a chase level. Oh! She scored the shooting range exams. I feel like the intent of these levels is not to show that Carmelita is a bad shot. It's to show that Sly is just really good at dodging them. But, oh boy. These games really do make her look like a bad shot. Whee! Whoa. Eight more. Four. Five. Oops. Shut up, Carmelita. Absolutely wrecking ship. Shop. Looks like that dog had yellow eyes. Those horrible yellow eyes! Finish it! Deliver us! Oh! There we are. Dunk. Dive. Got him. Oh, one left. One left. I hope I didn't miss it further back. Because if so, I'm going to have to do this level all over again. Oh, damn it. I may have to. We'll see. If I ended up missing it, I'll go back through the level. I'll exit the level and go back through. Because as far as I can remember, yeah, it looks like these are one-way exits. Oh, this one. Oh, boo. That reference just flew over my head. What reference? Which reference? I tend to like almost compulsively make references to stuff. Whoops. Oh, the yellow eyes one. That is a reference to Sam Raimi's Spider-Man, starring Tobey Maguire, the first live-action Spider-Man movie. There's a part where Green Goblin abducts, or not abducts, but like accosts and or, yep, okay, I missed one. Accosts and or attacks Aunt May. And I don't remember that line. Oh yeah, it's a part in near like either the midway point or near the end point where Aunt May is like saying her prayers for bedtime. And then all of a sudden her fucking, the side of her apartment blows up. And the Green Goblin flies and he's like, "Finish it!" And she's like, "Deliver us!" Like, as she's terrified. It's so goofy. And then, once she's like, he doesn't like hurt her or anything. I forget what happens, but like, she's found later. And, you hear her saying, "Those eyes! Those horrible yellow eyes!" Looking back now, it's so fucking doofy, and I love it. I'll make sure there's not one down here. Did you watch the English version of the movie, Mono, or did they translate it to Portuguese? I am curious about that. Both, okay. Well, also, that scene has, like, sort of turned into a meme by this point, which is very funny. Let's see. I want to see if I can get into a spot where she can't shoot me. That works. Okay, that's breakable. Oh, she got me anyway. Oh, boy. We have a strong dubbing culture. Oh, that's good. Nothing over here. Oh boy, this is frustrating. Let's see, anything over here? No. Wow, I don't know how I missed that. Sort of have our own memes. Norman Osborn line, "Am I in or am I?" has become. That's funny. Damn it. Where are you? Oh, wait. I think I see it. No? I thought I saw it. I know what I thought. Whoa. Ah, there it is. Oh my god, right here? Seriously? The easiest spot to see it? That's unbelievable. Okay. Now to the safe. Nope. Bop. But yeah, it looked like he had yellow eyes. Damn.
Good thing I know Navajo code talk.
Navajo code? What? Navajo code talk? What do Native Americans have to do with this?
Oh yeah, this will come in handy. It's Suzanne Cooper's notes pertaining to water safety.
Oh yeah.
This knowledge under your belt. You won't have to waste a charm whenever you fall into water.
That's so helpful. That's like one of the best ones. So now if I fall off of a ledge, I won't waste a, never mind, it's only in water. Shit. That's right, never mind. It's the, it's later on in the game that I get the one that allows you to not waste a charm whenever you fall off of any large ledge. Egg on my face. Camera, it would be very nice if you could. I'm just gonna do it myself. No, turn this way, please. Money, please. She says floating gently away on a fucking balloon. Damn. We got back alley heist. Bow wow. I don't know if y'all can hear that or not. Bow wow. That's funny. Okay, let's see where that is. Whoops. Back up we go. Bow owl? Not necessarily. Like, are you intentionally, like, saying it wrong as a bit? Or, is that legit? Yes. Okay, got it. Bow owl. It's the all owl cover band for Bauhaus. Oh, I remember this one. Aw, damn it! What a waste of a charm. I'm intentionally. Yeah, okay, gotcha. I didn't mean to ruin the joke, by the way. It's hard to tell sarcasm and stuff like that via text for me. No problem. Alright, cool. Oh. Triple bottles. Yeah. Oh, fuck. I just took the level over. Oh, it's so easy to miss that one. Let's try it again. Also, we will absolutely be able to, beat Muckshot before stream ends. 100%. I didn't even have to break that. That's cool. Oh, son of a bitch. Okay, cool. I had a I had a spare horseshoe. There we go. Really? Oh, I see. Really, I can't jump? Alright, whatever. Oh, what the fuck? $30 again for this level. Seems like so much. Alright, we're halfway there. Boy. Can I, like... Nope. Seems like there's no way to sneak up on guys in this game. Oh, there it is. Tear up all of the shit. Oh, there's a horseshoe. Fuck yeah. Hell yeah. Oh. Oops. I didn't realize you could fall in. I didn't realize it was deep enough to fall in. Okay, good. Ah, that's right. I remember that now. Oh, it's one of those long... Oops. Damn it. Once again. It's one of those long-nosed dogs. Didn't mean to do it for you. I love that meme. It's so silly. There was a VTuber. She's also a voice actress. Her name, she goes by Amelie. For April Fools, she had a model that was essentially one of those long-nosed dogs. And whenever she was facing the camera, the nose looked short, but whenever she turned her head, you could see the long snoot. It was very funny. Oh, that's right, I remember this part. Oh, I forgot you could move along the lines. There we go. Whoa. The tail sticking out. That's so funny to me. Can't see me. There's a YouTuber called Nutshell Animations. Guy did 3 videos using that audio clip. I mean, there's so much you can get out of it. Whoop! Oh, I remember this part. One more. No! Oh, damn it. Come on. The timing on this is so frustrating. Okay, got that one down. There we go. 10 more. What the hell? Whoa. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's probably what I should have used to grab the ones that were moving. Oh, this part's hard. Oh, we got it. I think I got them all. Let me check. Yes, we got them all. Cool. Four more. Oops. Hold on, let me check. Okay, yeah. I'm just break that window real quick. No. Get away! Peta, you've been wearing that giant green foam cowboy hat for 8 months. Please, for the sake of your family, take it off. Hey, I can take off this cowboy hat anytime I want. I just don't want to. Oh, that's such a good bit. Why the fuck is it like that? Wait. Hell yeah. This cowboy hat reference is from what now? Oh, sorry. That's from Family Guy. It's from an old episode. I really enjoy the first, like, 4 or 5 seasons of Family Guy.
The combination is 5-6-5.
But the later seasons are really boring, in my opinion. Only good for, like, small little clips that are funny. I've watched very few episodes in it, and they were all dubbed. Dubbed in English or Portuguese? Portuguese, yeah.
It's Sir Andrew Cooper's thief replica technique. He used to make fake stand-ups of himself to confuse guards.
Portuguese. Oh, cool.
The wrong thing. Use the triangle button to put together a fake Sly Cooper.
Sorry. Had some ear gunk in my headphones. The fuck? There we go. That was weird. Not sure why he walks on it like that. Bam! I think after I beat Mugshot, I'm gonna have to call it a stream because I have a sub job tomorrow morning. Thankfully, it's not too early in the morning. It's a half day, so I go in at about 11-ish. But I like to wake up about 2 hours before my shift starts. That way I have plenty of time to get ready. Do I have it all? I do. Don't mind if a dukes. Bam. It's just a fucking flip door. That's funny. The big old tongue.
Bleh.
No. Man, I need one more horseshoe for this fight. Because this fight gets hard. How many keys do you need? 7.
7 keys.
I don't know how popular Sesame Street was in Brazil, or is in Brazil. Where are you? Give me something to get coins from. 7. Oh, halfway. Let's see, what's this one? That'll work. That's gonna get enough coins to get the horseshoe and then exit the level. It is to an extent. Okay. I never do the time trials. Fuck the time trials. Time trials suck. So hard. Wait, I should probably... Oh, that's right, this one doesn't move. But these guys do. They fall? What the fuck? Those are seekers? Oh, and I lost my fucking... Oh, man. That's weird. But I've never bothered to watch it. Oh, okay. That's fine. What a waste. God damn it. All right, fine. I don't know how I managed to do this last time. What the hell? Also, if you die enough, they just give you a horseshoe, which is really funny. So while I'm figuring this out, where are you? Mine. There we go. Dive. Damn it! One of these days they're gonna give me a horseshoe. Come on, give me the horseshoe. I'm either gonna get that horseshoe or I'm gonna get one with money. Ah, damn it, I hit the wrong button. I had the wrong ability equipped. Stop following me! Of course you can't hit it back at him. That'd be silly. Never tried to before, so I figured it was worth a shot. Watch me waste all of my lives on this one part. I'm a stubborn, goddammit. Got him. There we go. Okay, fucking hell. There should be a horseshoe somewhere on this level. There's one horseshoe to get back that after I fucking wasted it. God damn it. The tip of my fucking foot touched it. Okay. Oh, there's one. Hell yeah. That's all I needed. Fuck off. Okay. Exit level. Now we got it. Okay. Too much shit. Bow wow. Bow wow. Zwing. Hell yeah.
What? My boys have been yapping about some big mysterious dude running around cracking skulls and this is it? You're the monkey wrench in my operation? Some scrawny rat with a stick! Wait a second. I seen that stick before.
Maybe when my father knocked your block off with it.
Your got him.
Father? Wow! You're a Cooper?
Cooper?
You know that Thingus Rackamagookus?
Rackamagookus.
Way too many big boys.
So you don't mind just handing it over?
What, are you kidding? You break into my place, steal my stuff, trash the joint. I feel
transgressed and violated.
Let's rock.
I love transgressed and violated from a fucking giant buff man. Oh, that's right. Oh my god, it's so easy to get hit by him. This is by far the second hardest fight in the game. There's three phases to it. Damn it! Gun is destroyed! Spare upstairs! So silly. Bam, bam, bam. Oh my god, I can't believe I lived for that after that one. Timing for these mirrors are so frustrating. The timing for the shots, I mean, of not getting shot. Got it. The Dark Souls of Slice series, don't say that. The Dark Souls of X has become so meaningless now. Okay. Oh. I think I may have messed up the timing. Yep, I messed up the timing. Fuck! Oh, so close! We got this. Oh, fuck. KBS is going down. Oh, and we're back up. We got this. Let's go counterclockwise, shall we? Brr. Oh, my God. How am I supposed to get behind him? Oh, my God. I cannot believe I fucking... Ugh. Oh. Oh, boy. What? Where? What, which one am I missing? Oh, I see it. There he is. Wait, where's the other one? Oh, man. His little icon in the bottom left-hand corner is so goofy. That's the first one. I'm gonna need to leave now. Wish you best of luck. All right, Mano. Thanks for stopping by for so long. Appreciate you. Good thing I got a spare upstairs. So silly. Not Philly. Silly. Philly is the abbreviation of Philadelphia. Or a small pony. Female pony? I don't remember. I never watched My Little Pony. But I was on Tumblr while it was enormously popular. There we go. All right, last part. Come on. Ooh, we got it. One more. That's game. Ha ha!
This is impossible. A little pipsqueak like you, beating a big, strong bruiser like me, it ain't right. All that stupid picture book. You're gonna have to go down to Haiti and cross paths with Ms. Rue. And then believe you me, you don't wanna be you.
You don't wanna be you.
The mugshot section of the Thievius Raccoonus contained an entry from my gunslinging ancestor, Tennessee Kid Cooper.
Hell yeah, I love this part. I love this ability.
His specialty was the rail walk and rail slide.
Rail slide.
Moves perfected through a lifetime of theft in the Old West. Getting out of town proved to be a little more challenging than getting in. Having just missed us, Inspector Fox went for the next best thing. And drag that canine steroid case off to jail.
Steroid case?
That was the end of Mugshot's gambling empire, and Mesa City's citizens soon returned home. While me and the boys, well, we enjoyed the rest of our stay in America, and then returned to Paris, ready for our next mission.
Fuck yeah. Alrighty. Up next is Ms. Ruby, which is in Haiti, of all places. Saving now. Alrighty. Thank you to everyone who decided to stop by even for a little bit. I appreciate you. Appreciate you. All lurkers are welcome. Hope y'all had fun watching as much as I had fun playing. Bam, bam, wham. Now I want to see who's online. Oh, actually, before I do that, let's pop the music back on, shall we? Shall we, shall we, shall we? Get out of my hair. Here we go. Okay. There we go. And I gotta fix the sound real quick. And refresh. While Spotify is refreshing, I will see who's streaming right now. Remedy. Charity Goblin. Icy Jackets. Oh, okay. Couldn't remember who that was. Crimbus McGrimbus. Ideal Goth Girlfriend. No one that I really know is currently streaming right now. So, I'm just going to call it a night with just some music. I appreciate everyone who stopped by. Oh, perfect. Sewer Slut. Hell yeah. Anyway, I appreciate all y'all very much. I should have the VOD for this stream uploaded within a couple of hours, give or take. We'll see. Until then, I wish you a lovely evening. Be safe. Be good to yourself, even if you don't feel like it. Even if you feel like you're not worth being good to. Be nice to yourself. And be nice to each other. Because as Kyle Hill says, this is all we got. Have a lovely evening and good night.